Good evening. I'm Senate President Roger Roth, and I represent Appleton and part of the Fox Valley, where my wife Rebecca and I live and raise our 5 young children. It's an honor for me to speak with you tonight and share the progress Wisconsin has made for our workers, businesses, and families all across our state. Wisconsin is doing great. The state of our state is very strong. In the last decade, Wisconsin Republicans have enacted reforms that continue to ignite our economy and have taken our state from budget deficits to budget surpluses. We've made investments in our state's infrastructure, worker training, and our kids' education. The results have been spectacular economic growth, record low unemployment, higher wages, and frozen college tuition, all without raising taxes. In fact, the average resident's tax burden is at its lowest level in nearly 50 years, while incomes continue to grow. That's a winning combination. It's the Wisconsin way, and it's all made possible by the tough reforms we passed that have proven to benefit Wisconsin families from Ashland to Whitewater and everywhere in between. The Republican budget we passed and signed into law prioritizes transportation infrastructure, education, and increased healthcare access for all Wisconsinites, all without asking you to pay more in taxes. We also invested more money in the state's rainy day fund, so in the event of an economic downturn, the state doesn't come running asking you to pay more at the worst possible time. Now, recently, Governor Evers was asked to grade his first year in office. He gave himself a grade of incomplete. I appreciate his honesty. Listening to Madison elites while ignoring the rest of Wisconsin isn't a recipe for success. Unfortunately, he has chosen to veto important legislation we crafted hand in hand with the people of Wisconsin. He vetoed a middle-class tax cut that would have provided $340 million in relief to hardworking families across our state. He vetoed a mental health crisis center in northwest Wisconsin in favor of sending that money to, you guessed it, Madison. Friends, he even vetoed a bill protecting our most vulnerable youths, babies born alive after a failed abortion. Yet despite all of this, we as Republicans are committed to continuing to find ways to work with our counterparts here in the Capitol, like we did with our most recent budget. We stand ready to work together in all things that hold true to the values of Wisconsinites and improve our state. The priorities that we'll be leading on over the next few months do just that. We'll be working on legislation to keep driving down healthcare costs, streamline inefficiencies in our government, protect our families with tougher penalties for repeat violent criminals, and return back to you your hard-earned money to lower property taxes. And we'll do all of this while defending your constitutional rights to free speech, to keep and bear arms, and due process under the law rights that some here in the Capitol are seeking to roll back. As a kid growing up in Menasha, I helped my father build houses at a very young age. I saw how coming together with your friends and your neighbors builds not only a home, but a community we can all be proud of. Like you, I know what it's like to put in a hard day's work, not giving up until the job's complete. We here in the legislature will never forget that as we continue to work to make sure that government barriers don't stand in the way of you pursuing your dreams. In 1851, when our forebears chose a motto for our great state, they settled on one simple yet powerful word, forward. I think that's because they were an unsatisfied people, always moving forward, always working to better their lives, to better their communities, and better their children's future. Come to think of it, they were a lot like you and me. And we here today are heirs to their faith, determination, and sacrifice. And so to you I say, come, let us go forward together. After all, it's the Wisconsin way. And on a personal note, I'd like to wish my beautiful wife, Rebecca, a happy 9th anniversary. And with that, from the Capitol, good night, and may God continue to bless our great state.